Love that.
Please don't leave.
We're good? We're live? Oh. You gotta tell John.
You gotta tell us, man.
Hi. So we're live from Brooklyn College Radio here. This is Comic Corner, and I'm your host, Kaylin Guzman. I'm joined here with
Christian.
And this is a special edition to our show, Comic Corner.
Yeah!
Woo!
Yeah!
We are outside on the quad.
Oh, it's so
we're
wild.
Having fun. But today's episode, like I said, is very special.
Very special.
Why is it special, Kaylin? Paramount Pictures reached out to us and sent us some prizes on preparation for Transformers Rise of the Beast.
Oh my god.
Yeah, which comes out June 9th, so you guys can catch it there. And so we'll have prizes and games out by the Library Cafe over here on Brooklyn College campus, and you guys could stop by and answer some trivia questions. Make sure that you're here enjoying the sun, the shade, the music that we will have courtesy of our DJ Chloe.
Woo!
She's over there. She's going to give us some bops from the 90s because that is our theme.
Oh, I love 90s. I was born in the 90s.
Yeah, the 90s are amazing.
What year were
and
you born in?
You were born in the 90s?
Technically, 99.
I was born in 2001.
Oh.
So, sorry. I missed the cutoff. So today's theme is 90s Transformers and Transformer trivia. So, I just want to point out that Christian is wearing a Superman t-shirt.
You don't have to.
You're not on brand, man.
Listen,
I'm wearing a Cars t-shirt, you
listen,
know.
Just, there's
we got to represent. We got to represent.
There are other Transformers besides Cars. As
do
you
they,
can see.
Do they look like do they look like Superman, though?
Probably.
No, they don't.
But I brought some of my toys from my collection, my action figures.
Yeah.
Collectible figures.
They're really cool.
Thank you.
Yeah, I like this one.
My mom says it's a waste of money. Onto the
nice joke.
It's not a joke.
We do have our team back there. I appreciate everybody that came out and helped us. We were stressing, but we got it going.
We did it. No one was
and
panicking.
So so should we start with some music?
Yeah, start with some music
from DJ Chloe, courtesy of Miss Chloe.
Chloe on the ones and twos.
Something new. Stop, drop, shut them down, open up shop. Oh, no, that's how rough fighters roll. Stop, drop, shut them down, open up shop. Oh, no, that's how rough fighters roll.
Snitches wanna try, what? Snitches wanna lie. What? Just wonder why, they just wanna die. All I know is pain, all I feel is rain. How can I maintain the madness on my brain? I resort to violence, my killers move in silence. Like you don't know what I silence, then your killers are wildest. My dogs is with it, you want it? Come and get it. Took it, then we split it, damn right we did it. What the F you gon' do, when we run up on you? Messing with the wrong crew, don't know what we going through. I'ma have to show how easily we blow. Let me find out there's some more that's running with Joe. We can't handle, break it up and dismantle, light it up like a candle, just cause I can't stand you, put my sp- on tapes, like you busting grapes, think you holding weight, and you haven't met the apes.
Stop, drop, shut them down, open up shop, oh, no, oh, no, oh, no, oh, no, oh, no, oh, no.
Remember when I used to eat sardines for dinner? Peace to Ron G, Brucey B, Kid Capri, Funk Master Flex, Love Bug Star Ski. I'm blowing up like you thought I would. Call a crib, same number, same hood. It's all good. And if you don't know, now you know. You know. Close and personal with Robin Leach, yeah. And I'm far from cheap. I smoke skunk with my peeps all day. Spread love, it's the Brooklyn way. The Moet and Alizé keep me pissy. Girls used to diss me, now they write letters cause they miss me. I never thought it could happen, this rapping stuff. I was too used to packing ice and stuff. Now honeys play me close like butter play toast. From the Mississippi down to the...
Hello, and we're back. Thank you, Chloe, for that wonderful music. And so... From the streets of Brooklyn to the jungles of Peru, Autobots, Maximals, thank you. And humans must unite as allies in the battle for Earth, starring Anthony Ramos and Dominique Fischbach. Check out Transformers Rise of the Beast in theaters nationwide on June 9th. And, you know, have a good time.
Yeah, it's going to be a good movie.
Yeah, the previous Transformers installations I've liked.
Yes.
Yeah, they've been great. Mm-hmm.
And then Bumblebee, which we will talk about in about 5-10 minutes.
Yeah, Bumblebee. We're going to do a review of Bumblebee because that is the one that just came out before.
Yeah.
But yeah, let's get back to some music with DJ Chloe.
Everybody to the wild, wild west. A state that's untouchable like Elliot Ness. The track hits your eardrum like a slug to your chest. Like a vest for your Jimmy in the city of sex. We in that sunshine state where the bomb ass him be. The state where you never find a dance floor empty and pimps be. On a mission for them greens. Lean mean money making machines serving fiends. I've been in the game for 10 years making rap tunes. Ever since honeys was wearing Sassoon. Now it's 95 and they clock me and watch me diamond shining. Like a Rob Liberace. It's all good. From Diego to the Bay. Your city is the bomb. If your city making pain. Throw up a finger if you feel the same way. Straight putting it down for California. Yeah.
Yeah. go down for G, but I somehow, some way, keep coming up with funky the shade like every single day. May I kick a little something for the G's and make a few wins as I breeze through. 2 a.m. and the party still jumping cause my mama ain't home. I got sisters in the living room getting it on and they ain't leaving till 6 a.m. So what you wanna do, bitch? I got a pocket full of rubbers and my homeboys do too. So turn off the lights and close the doors. But for what?
We don't love them.
Yeah. So we gon' smoke a slant to this. G's up, door down. While you look up for the bounce to this.
Rolling down the street, smoking in the mouth, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Rolling down the street, smoking in the mouth, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money.
Now back, I got me some Seagram's gin. Everybody got their cups, but they ain't chipped in. Now this type of shit happens all the time. You gotta get yours, but fool, I gotta get mine. Everything is fine when you're listening to the D.O.G. I got the cultivating music that be captivating me. Who listens to the words that I speak as I take me a drink to the middle of the street and get to mackin' to this chick named Shady. She used to be the homeboy's lady.
Oh, that bitch.
80 degrees when I tell that shit, please raise up off these D ingredients cause you get none of these. At ease. As I mob with the dog pound, feel the breeze. Shy up just.
Rolling down the street, smoking in now, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back.
With my mind on my money and my money on my mind.
Rolling down the street, smoking in now, sipping on gin and juice.
Laid back. Later on that day, my homie Dr. Dre came through with a gang to Tango Ray. And a fat ish that of some bubonic that made me choke. Eesh, this ain't no joke. I had to back up off of it and sit my cup down. Tango Ray and Chronic, yeah, I'm fucked up now. But it ain't no stopping. I'm still popping. Dre got some shit from the city of Compton to serve me. Not with a cherry on top. Cause when I bust my gun, I'm raising the bar.
Back with Comic Corner. Thank you, DJ Chloe. So we're gonna start off with our first trivia question. So one of our guests can come on over and sit right next to us.
Anyone from the
whoever
audience.
Wants to.
Anyone.
Yeah, Sean.
Yes,
so
Sean.
Our first guest is Sean, and he's gonna answer our first trivia question. If you get more than one right, you could get a bigger prize. But if you get the first one wrong, then you will be eliminated. Like, by Decepticon. No, I'm kidding. So,
would you like a regular question or a true or false question?
I'll do true or false.
True or false? Okay. First true or false question.
Are you ready for this, Sean?
Yeah.
This is, like, the hardest question you will ever receive.
Okay.
Okay, true or false? The Transformers learn how to speak English through the internet. True or false?
True or false?
I'll go with false.
False?
Is that the correct answer?
It is incorrect.
You are incorrect.
They did learn through the internet.
Thank you.
Damn, Sean. Right. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
We need a next guest got it wrong.
Another audience member.
A new one. Let's cycle through another one.
Oh, my God. Who is that coming?
Oh, my God. It's the famous Bree Underwood. Yes.
Hello.
Hi, Bree. How are you today?
I am doing all right. Excited to be here.
All right. If you get one question wrong, you're eliminated.
Oh, brother.
Yeah. So if you get more than one right, you could get a bigger prize.
Yeah. So, same question. Would you like a regular trivia question or a true or false question?
Give me true or false. That's 50-50.
Another one. Okay. So, true or false? Megatron and Optimus Prime are brothers.
True?
That is incorrect.
Brothers. Well, our first trivia people have gotten them wrong. That's a shame. Yeah. But we do have more prizes to come. Yes. We're going to now review Bumblebee.
Yes. And talk about the Bumblebee movie.
This is the installation previous to this one.
Yes.
With Haley Seinfeld.
Yes.
Playing like the main lead.
Yeah.
With Bumblebee.
Yes. So, what did you think of the movie?
I liked it.
Did you?
I think it's one of my favorites out of the original Transformers.
Yes.
Yeah.
I want in the beginning of the scene where like they're all on Cybertron.
Yeah.
That looks really cool. I wish like that was like a whole separate movie. Mm. Just that part. Yeah, like it shows like the G1 accurate Transformers. That is a fly.
Yeah.
And I really like the aesthetic. I like how everybody's like fighting to get on the ship because they're trying to leave the planet. Mike mm-hmm. is not working.
Well, it's Bumblebee's like panic that gets him to Earth.
Yes, after he sees Optimus Prime almost die, basically. That's exactly what happened. Mm-hmm. We saw the movie last night. I don't really remember exactly. So, this movie, the Bumblebee movie, is set in 1987.
And
the new movie, Transformers Rise of the Beasts, is set in 1996.
So 96.
I was thinking, what if she came back in this movie as like a post-credits?
In the post-credits?
Yeah. Like how old would she be? She was 18 in 1987. How old would she be in 1996 or 4?
I don't do math. How long is that? It's like 14
so
years?
So she would be like early 30s?
Yeah.
She could totally come back. So I just thought that.
So she could come back and give us some more content. Yeah, but more they would have stuff. To age her up with like CGI and things like that. I don't think that would be...
Haley Stanford looks old enough.
No. She looks too young to be 30.
That's right.
But anyways, I like the scene where she's like jumping off the cliff. Well, she's about to, and then she hesitates because she's a cliff diver and she had a previous accident, I believe.
No, she did it because her dad died.
Yes, her dad died.
She felt sad.
Yeah.
I really liked that. I liked how, you know, they set it up in the beginning of the movie mm-hmm. where like those bullies. Well, first off, why those bullies?
There's always a bully.
Annoying.
There's always a bully.
The girl makes a joke about how, like, oh, I'm sorry, your dad's dead.
Yeah.
Like, that's uncalled for.
Yeah, so insensitive. I don't think they should have included
that joke.
First off,
it's insensitive on Bumblebee because he, like, pushes her. Mm-hmm. He opens a door.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong. I like Bumblebee. He's adorable in this movie. But, like, come on, man. Don't listen. Listen to your owner, technically. Is she his owner?
That's the weird thing. Like, I would say they're friends. It's kind of like a pet thing.
Yeah, like a companion.
Because they're not really like animals, so they can't own. Like,
they have free will.
There's a lot of weird things happening in these franchises. Yes.
I thought that maybe if they try to reestablish, because this movie is technically a reboot.
Yeah.
I will get into that later, but I was thinking the perfect way for like them to connect the previous five Transformers movies.
Right.
And this one is to have maybe like Charlie be like Megan Fox's mom. Kind of like establish that. Because in the movies that Megan Fox is in, like she's shown like being a good like car mechanic or like knowing how to do car stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
So like maybe she learned from her mother. Because that would be cool. Or like her grandmother or something. I don't know.
Yeah, that could be a good connection transition-wise. But I don't think... Do you think they want to connect them back to the original?
Yeah, I don't think so. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't think they want to be connected to Mr. LaBeouf. So.
Yeah. In the movie, there's her uncle owns a junkyard shop.
Right.
And that's where she finds Bumblebee. Mm-hmm. But, like, he just gives her the car because I guess it's her birthday.
Yeah.
But, like, at the same time, that's not, you're not making money off of that if you just give people cars, like junk cars. Like, it's not a very good business.
Yeah, but he probably has more customers.
Yeah, but it's like a nice car.
Yeah, but are you really judging the...
Yes, I am judging the
movie. Yeah.
Listen, this isn't a comic book movie, but I'm still judging it like it is a comic book movie.
Yeah, but it's not... It's a movie. They needed a way to get the car to her, and that might be the most reasonable one, especially because it's like an endearing gift to this person.
It's a birthday gift.
Yeah. Right, because he's like his, is it her grandfather?
I think it was her uncle. Oh, so her uncle is... I didn't think they were related. I'm just like, just a random guy. But then later she said, like, oh, the uncle, my uncle got it for me. I was like, oh, that's her uncle.
So well, I was like, oh. I don't know.
Anyway, that was a bad point. Anyway, another point I want to mention is, do you think it hurts when the Transformer, like, transforms?
No.
Like, do you think it hurts them? Because they have to, like, contort and, like, fold.
I don't think so, because they... If you use WD-40, no rust, then you, like,
just in
you know.
The joints?
Yeah.
I just don't know. Because I feel like, because at the end of the movie.
And the screws in the joints.
Yeah, the screws in the joints.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the movie, Bumblebee throws a chain on the bad Transformer.
Uh-huh.
And, like, he tries to transform, but, like, the chains are stuck.
But that's different, because you're introducing a whole new mechanic to a car.
Yeah, but it still has to hurt.
No, the chain definitely
hurts.
Yeah,
the chain definitely hurts. That's what killed
but
him.
But, like, the transforming, I don't think hurts. It's like bending your elbow for them. You know? Like, walking around is for them the same thing as transforming in between an automobile and normal transformer form. What even are the forms called? Anyways.
I have a follow-up question.
Yeah.
Can the Transformers control, like, the speed at which they transform? Because, you know, sometimes they take
it does
like
happen
5 minutes.
Fast. Yeah, it can
like,
happen
do,
fast and it can
choose,
happen slowly.
Like, do they choose how fast they transform?
That's what I'm saying. It's probably like the fold of your elbow, you know? You could choose to go slow motion or you could choose to go fast.
I don't get it. I don't know Transformers.
And that's why they're aliens.
They're robot aliens.
Yeah.
Also, I wanted to point out, is Bumblebee like a short king?
Yeah, he is the shortest one. Yeah.
And, like, I kind of respect him for it. So good for him.
Good for him. Yeah. Short king.
I don't want him to be, like, this big. He's
yeah.
nice and small.
Is he shorter than this? Than this
I
one?
I mean, because that, it's, okay, so this, the toys are a different thing because the toys are different sizes.
Okay.
And they're different continuities.
Okay.
So, no. But probably.
But, like, which one's this one?
That's Optimus Prime.
Okay. But he's shorter than Optimus Prime.
Yes.
Yeah. So he's probably like around here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's probably more like him. No, because he's in the... So this one, mm-hmm. the dinosaur is from the video game.
Right.
And that's from an alternate universe where the Decepticons or the Autobots. See, he's in purple.
Yeah.
So he's the bad guy. And Megatron's the good guy. That's an alternate universe. And that's just Megatron.
Cool.
But they all come in different sizes. Like this one... He's Voyager class.
Yeah.
And he's like leader class. And he's also leader class. But in the game, I think he's taller than Optimus Prime.
Yeah.
But it's a different version of Optimus Prime.
Right.
It's very confusing. In layman's terms, yes, Bumblebee is shorter than everybody.
Ah.
So yes, and I don't want to like, how do I say this? Bumblebee's like, I like Bumblebee. Like every
you
time
like Bumblebee?
We're like, she gives Bumblebee a hug.
Yeah.
I was like, that's adorable. Like, I want to hug Bumblebee.
Well, you could probably find a
no,
like
real Bumblebee.
Costume player.
I don't want to find a costume
and Times Square.
No.
Dressed as Bumblebee.
Speaking of
and Bumblebee. And they transform.
Oh, yeah, they do
transform. They do transform. They,
speaking
like,
of transform,
crouch on the floor.
Would you be scared if, like, you saw, like, a Transformer just, like, out in the open?
No.
Because, like, the guy...
You've been desensitized.
I know. No, but I'm saying, like, if it's, like... fresh, like you see a car,
yeah,
and then it just gets up and transforms into like a 20-foot robot, would you get like scared?
Probably.
But what if it was Bumblebee? Like, I get if it was like
you would still, it's still an unknown machine to you. You don't know what it would do to you.
I feel like I wouldn't get scared, maybe because I'm desensitized. But like the guy in the movie, his
yeah.
name's Memo. think that was his name.
Yeah.
He gets scared. He screams. And I was like,
Come on. Yeah, when they're in the warehouse.
Yeah.
Yeah, in the train.
That's not scary. He's like, it's like an insect. Like, he's more scared of you than you are of him.
Oh. So I don't know. Well, it's still a scary experience.
You
wouldn't get scared because you live in a universe where they've been introduced to you. If you live in a universe where this never existed and all of a sudden it did, you would be scared. That's just how the human experience works.
Yeah, probably.
That's just how it works, you know?
Like, I would get scared for the first 10 minutes.
You're scared of the unknown and the impossible.
What are you, the Flash?
No.
We're not talking about the Flash, we're talking about Transformers. Transformers all day, every day.
Yeah.
No comic books, even though yesterday, Wednesday, was the series finale of the Flash. We're not going to talk about that.
Transformers.
Yes. Halfway through the movie,
yeah,
I just like stopped taking notes.
Why?
I was just enjoying the movie.
It was
a really good movie. I liked it. Did you see it in
theaters? It's a good movie. No, I did not see it in theaters.
I
watched it at home for the first time.
Paramount Plus.
Yes.
Yeah, anyway, so see it with Paramount. It's a good streaming service.
Yeah.
Yes. What else did I want to say? At the very end, she did the thing. That she wanted, she did the dive thing.
Mm-hmm.
She did it in like jeans.
That's so cool.
She did it in jeans.
I like that shot. That shot is fantastic.
It's a good shot.
Yeah.
But like, having wet jeans is like so annoying.
Did she take off her shoes?
Nope.
No.
Nope. She takes off her jacket.
Well, she had to save her friend.
I get it.
To save her friend.
But like, I don't know.
She had to save her friend. If you had to save your friend in the middle of the ocean, would you take your time to take off your shoes and your jeans?
I mean, there's a lot of variables when it comes to that. Who is the friend?
Oh, my God.
What am I wearing? What's, like, the weather? Because what if the water is cold? And, like, I'm like, not wearing anything.
Right.
So it's a lot of variables. And plus, if it was a family member, then yes, I would jump in.
Mm-hmm.
But if it was just, like, a friend? Like,
if it was a family member, he's going to say he wouldn't save me.
I would. Right? I feel like now we're good. We're friends.
Yeah, we're friends.
Good friends.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You're not looking at me when you say yeah. It feels disingenuous.
Why are we talking about this now?
I don't know. I just
wanted to extend it. Haley Seinfeld.
Yes.
Jumps off.
Charlie. I don't know.
Charlie jumps off, lands her dive into the
water,
the
little dam
that is from a dam, right?
Yeah, it's like a mini
dam. And then Bumblebee is at the bottom of the water.
Yeah.
And
she doesn't pick him up.
How does
I think he just gets up.
He probably gets up and then takes her up with him. Because she cannot lift
There's
the
no
car.
Way.
She is not going to be able
Even
to lift
the
car.
Even in the water.
Unless she's superhuman.
Maybe she...
Maybe
my shirt makes sense.
Oh, my God. Maybe she is Superman.
I plan ahead of time on my outfits. Totally not because I didn't have a Transformer shirt. I thought I did.
Yeah, you
but
didn't.
But I didn't. Mm. And I was like, this is the next closest thing.
I have a car shirt, so.
Yeah, but that does whatever.
It doesn't. Well, why don't they have a Ford Mustang Transformer?
They do.
Do they?
Not in this movie.
No, they don't. They only have Camaros. Or Camaros.
Camaro.
Yeah.
I think they have a.
Yellow with the black.
Listen,
racing stripe in the middle.
We don't have good internet, so I can't find out. But I'm pretty sure there is a Ford Mustang.
I've never seen a Ford Mustang. I've seen, like, I think there's a McLaren. There's obviously the truck, the trailer.
The Lamborghini.
They have the Lamborghini.
Dinosaurs.
I think they have GTs.
I don't know what a GT is.
Like
a fast car. I don't know cars.
A fast car.
Probably a fast car.
But I don't know if they have a Ford Mustang. And you should.
Maybe in the next one.
Maybe in this one, right?
In Transformers Rise of the Beast, there is. And it'll be your favorite character.
Yeah, it will be.
It probably should be. at the end of the movie, we're like jumping around different... Oh, God.
I got it. Don't worry
about it. At the end of the movie, when they like they separate at the end because Bumblebee has to go with Optimus Prime to do stuff. Bumblebee just like leaves.
Yeah.
Leaves her by the bridge. Like, you could have taken her home. Come on, Bumblebee. Don't
yeah. Like he could have driven her home and dropped her off.
Yeah. And, like, he turned into, like, a different car. So, like, you're telling me the entire movie
he
didn't see a
He, like,
car.
Upgraded, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, like, he didn't see a better car the entire time except for right at the end.
Yeah.
Where he's like, oh, that's a good car. And he just turns into that car.
Yeah. I mean, like he was driving away, and he was like, you know what? I got to change.
I had to look different.
I got to look different so my friend over here doesn't find me ever again.
Oh, don't say that.
Yeah.
Don't say that. They should find each other in the end.
Yeah, so.
One sec.
What else do you want to say about this movie?
I want to talk
about... I like the graphics. I like the acting.
Yes, everything.
And I really enjoyed Bumblebee in this movie.
Yes. He got his memory taken away, which I forgot happened.
And he forgot how to talk and everything.
Well, he got stabbed in the throat by the bad guy.
Oh, yeah, he did.
He did get stabbed. Which happens in, like, every movie. Not saying it's a bad thing. I'm just saying it's a bad
thing. But he talks through his radio, yeah.
Yes.
And he changes everything.
Yes.
I think that's an innovative way of character creation.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, it was in the other movie, so it would make sense for him to have it in this movie.
Yeah.
I wanted to bring up that the reason why this is a reboot, technically, is because at the very end of this movie, Bumblebee finds Optimus Prime.
Yeah.
And then him and Optimus Prime talk, have a little chat.
Yeah.
A little meet cute. I don't know what it's called.
Meet cute, yeah.
And he looks up, and then he sees, like, seven other Transformers.
Mm-hmm.
Theoretically, other Autobots.
Yeah.
But, this is where it's different.
Autobots, roll out.
Yes. But, in the first movie...
Yeah.
Bumblebee's already on Earth, which is already established.
Yeah.
But then, there was four other Autobots that come to Earth. Because there was Optimus Prime, who's coming to Earth. And then there's another one, Ironhide, who's like a pickup truck.
Mm-hmm.
There's Ratchet, who's like an ambulance. And
yeah.
And there's the... I don't know what the last one is.
Yeah.
So there's already four. So like it already broke the universe because Optimus Prime is like coming back to Earth.
Okay.
So he wasn't
on
Earth.
So how can they... What are your expectations for this new movie?
For the next one?
Yeah, for this new movie that we're basing it off of. Transformers Rise of the Beast. What are your expectations?
I think that... The regular Autobots and the Maximals, they're going to do the classic formula.
Right.
Where they're going to fight for a bit.
Uh-huh.
Because there's two leaders. There's a giant truck and a gorilla. And then at the end of the movie, they're going to find a common threat and then beat the bad guy. And then set up another movie, probably.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
I mean, either way, I'm excited to see.
Yes.
Well, I loved rewatching this movie.
Yes. Overall,
it was fantastic.
Your score? What was your score? Are we still doing the chicken nuggets thing?
Yeah, let's do out of 55 chicken nuggets.
55
how
chicken
many?
Nuggets.
How many would we give this movie?
50 chicken nuggets. Actually, 50? You know what?
52. I would give it 40.
I would give it 52 chicken nuggets.
I would give it 40. I don't think it's like up there for me.
It's pretty good.
It is a good movie. That's why I gave it 40.
All right.
You
so
can get two.
You can get 2 for $20.
2 for $20.
That's next up on the agenda.
So now we're going to go back to DJ Chloe. She's going to drop some beats for us, and I hope you enjoy them.
Who sell out in the stores? You tell me who flop. Who cop the blue drop? Who jewels got pop? Who mostly Gucci down to the blue drop? The same old pimp. Mace, you know ain't nothing changed but my limp. Can't stop till I see my name on a blimp. Guarantee a million shells full of love and luck. You don't believe in Harlem World? Double up. We don't play around. It's a bet. Lay it down. Niggas didn't know me 91. Bet they know me now. I'm the young Harlem with the Goldie sound. Can't no PhD. Hold me down. Cooler. School me to the game. Now I know my duty. Stay humble. Stay low. Blow like Hootie. True pimp. Spin no dough on the booty. Yeah, there go Mace. There go your cutie. See me die, then see me fly. I call all the shots, rip all the spots, rock all the rocks, top all the drops. I'm never thinking now when all the ball stops. You never home, gotta call me on the yacht. 10 years from now, we'll still be on top. Yo, I thought I told you that we won't stop. Now what you gonna do with a crew that got money much longer than yours? And a team much stronger than yours. Violate me, this'll be your day. We don't play, mess around, be...
be on your way. Cause it ain't enough time here. Ain't enough lime here for you to shine here. Deal with many women, but treat down fair. And I'm bigger than the city lights down in Times Square. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Federal agents mad cause I'm flagrant. Tap myself and the phone in the basement. My team supreme, stay clean. Triple beam, miracle dream. I'll be that, catch a seat at all events bent. Send holsters, girls on shoulders. Playboy, I told ya, me and Mike to me. Bruise too much, I lose too much. Step on stage, the girls boo too much. I guess it's cause you run with lame dudes too much. Me lose my touch, never that. If I did, ain't no problem. And get the where the true players at. Throw your rollies in the sky, waving side to side, and keep your hands high while I give your girl an eye. Player please, lyrically, you can see B.I.G. be flossing, jig on the cover of Fortune, 500. Hit my phone number, your man, I got the know. I got the dough, got the flow down, Pizzak, Platinum Plus, like Fizzak, Dangerous, on Trizak, leave your ass Pizzak.
Come on. ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you and take it slowly. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. Gonna find you.
Girl, what can I do?
Here with this handsome kid, sick a cigar right from Cuba Cuba. I just bite it, it's for the look, I don't light it. Ill way to hand me on the hands, they all play. Give it up, Jiggy, make it feel like foreplay. Yo, my cardio is infinite. Ha ha, Big Willie Styles all in it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. You on the ball with your kid? Watch your step, you might fall trying to do what I did. Mama, I'ma come close side in the middle of the club with the rubber dub. No love for the haters. Mad cause I got floor seats at the Lakers. See me on the 50-yard line with the Raiders. Met Ali, he told me I'm the greatest. I got the fever for the flavor of a crowd pleaser. DJ play another from the Prince of this, your highness. Only bad chicks riding my whip. South to the west, to the east, to the north. Bump my hips and watch them go off. But go off, but yes, yes, sure. And you don't stop in the winter order.
Summertime.
I mix it hot, getting jiggy with them. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. 850 IS if you need a lift. Who's the kid in the drop? Who else will slip? Living that life so better. From street to two. Used to tell me, human nice.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's unheard of. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking, or you and your homies might be lying in chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta low. As they grope, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of need a little homies wanna be like. On my knees in the night, saying prayers in the streetlight.
Been spending most of my life living in the hipster's paradise. Been spending most of my life living in the hipster's paradise. Been spending most of my life living in the hipster's paradise. Been spending most of my life living in the hipster's paradise.
Look at the situation they got me facing. I can't live a normal life. I was raised by the street, so I gotta be down with the hood team. Too much television watching got me chasing dreams. I'm an educated fool with money on my mind. Got my 10 in my hand and a gleam in my eye. I'm a low-down gangster, set-tripping banker.
and my homies is down, so don't arouse my anger. Fool, death ain't nothing but a heartbeat away. I'm living life, do or die. What can I say? I'm 23 now, but will I live to see 24? The way things are going, I don't know.
Tell me, why are we so blind to see that the ones we hurt are you and me? We've been spending most of our lives living in the gangster's paradise. We've been spending most of our lives. Oh, I'm on, yeah.
But I thought that was home.
Yes, I did.
But I guess you didn't know. As they said, the story told. Start. Baby, when you broke my heart, that I had it on my day, I'm sure you that I win. You lied to me. All those times I said that I love you, you lied to me. Yes, I tried, yes, I tried. You lied to me. Even though you knew I'd die for you, you lied to me. Yes, I cried, yes, I cried.
I'm Kaylin, if you forgot. I don't know if you forgot. Maybe you did.
Yeah, maybe they have short-term memory.
And so right now, we're going to hear the bell ring.
Yes.
Because that happens.
First off, late, let it finish.
Yeah. It's wonderful to have this bell at Brooklyn College.
Every 15 minutes.
Yep. It lets you know if you're being late. Yes. You know, even if it's 3, you're going to be late for your 3:15 class.
Even though it's finals week.
Yeah. So right now we're going to transition into some trivia.
More trivia.
People are going to be winning prizes if they get some questions correct. Our first guest is coming on over, and I don't know your name. I'm so sorry.
Sorry.
Cody. Cody. How are you, Cody?
Yay.
So, Cody, how are you today?
I'm good. Good.
That's. Oh, you picked up your cap and gown. Cool. Congratulations on graduating. So our first question is going to be from Christian.
Yeah.
You have a chance of winning a cup. Mm-hmm. If you get 2 correct, you could win a speaker, mm-hmm. transformer. And it looks like a little cute, like, you know, tape recorder.
Yeah.
No, that's not the right one.
That's not.
It's a
and
tape.
If you get all 3 of them correct, you get something else. Anyway.
If you get 5 right, you get our big prize. One of those over there with Chloe over there. You could win one of the Anchor power banks. So you could, yeah. Come on, don't be shy. We'd love to hear your beautiful voice. So Chris is going to start telling us the questions, and then good luck, man.
Thank you.
Do you know Transformers?
Yes.
All right, cool. So let's.
He answers all of them, right?
Oh, God. All right, so first question. What year did the first live-action Transformers movie come out?
I'm going to say 2005.
It was actually 2007.
Damn, you were close. Yeah. Okay, you were close.
By two years.
Let's give him another question. Let's give you another question.
Okay. How many Transformers movies are there in total? Excluding this one is about to come out.
Yeah, excluding the new one.
Rise of the Fallen.
Uh-huh.
Take your time.
Take your time. Think about it. There's
a
lot.
Would Bumblebee count as one?
Yes.
Oh, okay. I'm going to say last night. Six.
Six?
That is correct.
Yeah! Woo! Okay, so out of six questions, you have one right. We could keep going. You want to keep going?
Yeah.
Because you could get the cup or you could keep going.
It's like a game show.
Uh-huh.
You want to keep going?
If I get the next one wrong, I get nothing though, right?
No, well, you have six tries. You already have one left.
Mm-hmm.
So if you get all the rest of these, you can get that power bank.
I'll go.
You want to keep going?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So next question. What type of car is Bumblebee in the first movie?
In the first movie.
First movie.
What is the first movie? What are you counting the first movie to be?
The first
movie.
Isn't he a Chevrolet?
That is he. That's the brand. What type of car is he?
Yeah.
Camaro.
Not the first one.
Camaro.
A Charger? It's not a Charger?
No, it is a Chevy Camaro.
Oh, man. Okay, so right now you don't have the possibility of getting that power bank, but you do have a possibility of getting one of these speakers.
Uh-huh.
So if you get the next one right, you can take one of these home with you.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Here is a true or false question.
True or false? You have 50-50 chance. 50-50.
All right.
50-50 chance.
So, true or false, every Autobot's eyes are blue and every Decepticon's eyes are red. True or false?
That's false.
It's false? That's incorrect. It's
true.
Doesn't Grimlock count as an Autobot?
Yeah, I don't know these technical questions, man.
I found these questions on a weird list.
Wait, what is your evidence? Come on.
Because I thought if Grimlock was a kind of as an Autobot, I think he has either yellow eyes or, the dinosaur.
Oh.
The dinosaur.
They call them Dinobots.
I didn't even know there were dinosaurs.
We can give him half a point. He backed it up. He showed his work.
Well, we don't want you walking away with anything. So I'm going to give you a cup.
Uh-huh.
Cup.
Thank you.
Cup. And.
Yes, Cody. Thank you for coming on. You were a fantastic guest. You did your best. Thank you for having us.
Thank you so much.
That's not the right. And so we're going to continue with some of our other guests that we have back there. We're going to cycle through. Who wants to be next? Lewis. Yes, Lewis. Woo woo. Yeah.
All right.
So, Lewis, how confident are you in your Transformer knowledge?
Back in my younger days, I was a big Transformers guy. So I had like one of those Optimus Prime things, like the big truck that turned into like a little gun.
Like this one?
Yeah, just like that. But it also turned into a truck, 2-in-1, you know?
Oh, mm-hmm. Cool.
Yeah.
Okay, so Christian's going to keep asking you questions.
All right.
Again, you have six tries. If you get five right, you get one of those power banks. If you get three right, you get one of these. If you get one right, you could get one of these.
Okay.
Ready?
I'm prepared.
So, first question. Who is the leader of the Autobots?
That's got to be one of the easiest questions. It got to be Optimus Prime?
Yes.
Hey.
Yay. One down.
There we go.
Five to go.
Next, ask me who's the leader of the Decepticons.
No, four to go.
No, now it's going to be harder.
Okay, thank you.
It's going to be harder now.
Okay. I forgot to do that. What is the name of the home planet of the Transformers?
The home planet?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Where are they from?
Give him some multiple
this
choice.
This is where
would
I'm,
you like a multiple choice?
Oh, I would love. Oh, yes, I would. Thank you.
Okay.
Increase my odds, please.
Yes. A, yes. Earth. B, Mars. C, Cybertron. Or D, they don't live in a planet.
I think, didn't, Because in some of the movies, they are on Earth, but then they're not. I don't know. I'm going to just go with the one that sounds futuristic-y and Kari. Cybertron?
Is that your final answer?
Yes.
That is correct.
Hey! You got two right.
I would have picked Earth if it wasn't for Cybertron.
You're in the running for one of these speakers, so let's keep going.
All right, so next question. In which movie did Optimus Prime die in?
Wasn't that... Ooh.
Do you have like an idea?
Choice? It was... Oh, I would love a multiple choice, please. Okay. Multiple choices is
a,
just the best.
He never dies. B, he dies in Transformers Dark of the Moon.
Okay.
C, he dies in Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. Or D, he transforms... I mean, he dies in every single one.
Well, that's not true. The D is just not even close. It's either B or C. Tell me B or C again.
B, he either dies in Transformers 3, or C, he dies in Transformers 2.
So I think he said Dark,
B or C.
You said Dark Moon?
Darker than Moon is the third one.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to go with the second option.
Transformers Revenge of the Fallen?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Are you sure? Are you sure?
I'm going to say that every time.
Are you sure?
You know what? I'm going to go third one. I'm going to go third one.
The third movie?
The third movie?
Yes.
That is incorrect.
Oh.
It was the Revenge of the Fallen.
Yeah, Revenge of the Fallen.
It was the second one.
Yeah. But you still have more chances. Yes. Don't give up yet.
I'm not giving up hope,
guys. Ask him the next question.
Come on.
This next
one.
This next one is a true or false question.
Okay.
In the first Transformers movie,
true.
There was a Transformer.
Released in what year?
We already did that one.
2007.
Mm-hmm. There was a Transformer that transformed into a Mountain Dew vending machine. True or false?
True or false? You got 50-50.
First movie, 2007, Mountain Dew.
Vending machine, yes.
Yeah.
And then he transforms. True or false?
I'm going to go with true. Because that probably, for the time, probably was peak comedy. I'm going to go true.
Peak comedy?
I'm going to go true.
That is correct.
Hey!
So, you got two wrong?
Well, technically I got three right. And then
you got
two,
three right,
and then one
two wrong.
Wrong. Two wrong.
One wrong.
Yeah, one well, wrong. Only here. One.
Here's the speaker.
Thank you.
Courtesy of Paramount Pictures. Hey. Thank you so much for signing this over.
Winner. Thank you.
Lewis, thank you for participating. Right, we're going to take our next guest. Do
next
we have
guest.
Time for a new guest?
Do we have another audience member?
Do we have another audience member that wants to do some trivia?
Wants to do some trivia?
Does anybody want to do some
anybody
trivia?
Else in our massive studio audience.
Yeah,
yes!
Trivia. Oh, I guess we'll do
another person trivia.
Yes, Jess, come sit down. How confident are you in your Transformers knowledge?
As confident as I need to be right now.
Yes. Okay, that's what we like to hear. Christian will continue to ask you questions.
I get multiple choice, right?
There
yes.
are true and false questions,
okay.
and then there are multiple choice answers.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So, first question. Who is the leader of the Decepticons?
Oh, God.
The Decepticons.
Yes.
I forgot his name.
Okay. This is why we have multiple choice.
These are multiple choices.
Okay.
A, Optimus Prime.
No.
B, Ravage.
No.
C, Soundwave. Or D, Megatron.
Megatron.
That is correct. Yay!
Correct. Woo! Jess, yes. Okay, yes. You got one out of five. Let's keep going.
All right. We're going to keep the Megatron questions coming.
Oh, God.
How many times has Megatron died in the movies? Multiple choice. A, he has never died. B, he has died once. C, he has died twice. Or D, he dies in every single one.
Come on, Jess. You got this.
You got this. 25%.
You got this.
I think he definitely dies in one of them.
Mm-hmm.
Does he die multiple times?
He might not die at all.
Yeah.
He might die in every movie.
Yeah, we never
Who
know.
Who knows?
I don't know.
Not, because I've seen some of them.
Okay.
So you would know the answer.
I'm going to say he dies once.
Is that your final answer?
Is that your final answer?
Yeah.
incorrect. He's died twice.
Which was the second one? Time. Which one did he die?
He dies once in
the first movie.
Okay, that's the one. Okay.
And in the third movie, he also dies because Optimus Prime rips his head off.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I get another question?
Yeah, you get another try.
Yeah, one more question. Okay. All right, this is a true or false question. True or false, Optimus Prime has transformed into a plane.
He has if it's true? I don't think I've ever seen him transform into a plane.
50-50. I don't know, Jess. 50-50.
True or false?
False.
That is correct.
Yay!
He's never transformed into a plane. In the live action movies. Okay, so we have... I don't have that many questions left.
Ask her one more question.
You get one more question to win this speaker.
The speaker.
This is another true or false question. True or false, Michael Bay has directed all 5 of the Transformers live-action movies.
False.
That is incorrect.
What?
He has directed all 5.
All of them?
Yes.
Didn't he have a falling out with somebody?
Yes.
That almost made him not do it? Or
I don't know.
I don't know
the Michael Bay lore.
I'm confusing him with another one of his franchises.
Yes.
Maybe.
There was one he... Okay, I'm going to stop talking.
Well, anyways, Jess, you do get a cup.
Yay!
Thank you for participating.
Thank
you for coming.
All right.
Do we have time for more trivia?
I don't think so.
Mike, would you like to come do some trivia? Yes, Mike is an audience member.
Yes.
I feel like he will probably get all of them right.
I don't know, man. I've been sitting off to the side thinking to myself a couple of these. I'm like, did I get that one right? No. That one? Kinda. Let's see what you got.
Okay. First question.
I also need you to know I'm going to ask you questions, so I hope you have answers.
Oh, this wasn't in the script.
This wasn't in the script.
All right. First question. Which Transformers TV show is the inspiration for this upcoming movie?
Upcoming?
Yeah. So Transformers Rise of the Beast has...
Is based off of
what? Oh, the animated show where they did the dinosaurs, Optimus Prime was a gorilla.
But what is it called?
Ooh, that's a good question.
Thank you.
Is that a multiple choice?
Yes, it is multiple choice. just Transformers.
No, regularly. Incorrect. Keep going.
B, Beast Wars. Ooh. C, Transformers Rise.
Nope.
With a Y.
That's not cool. Ooh.
Oh. And
crazy.
Transformers D, the Transformers, because they say the Transformers.
Yeah, now it's B.
It's B, Beast Wars?
Yeah.
He made that too
correct.
Easy.
No, I was going to say. The first one was, is it Transformers? And the last one was the Transformers? I was just
some
like, that's the
different.
One where they turn into animals and dinosaurs?
Okay, we have 2 more questions.
Uh-huh.
They are both true or false questions.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
So first true or false question. Transformers eat other Transformers to live.
Oh, that's a great question. False.
That is correct. They don't.
Woo!
Yeah, I was like, what?
Yeah, you got that wrong.
Yay. And last transform.
Could you imagine they're carnivorous? What are we talking about? This is for children?
I don't know, that would be crazy. Anyway, so last question. If you get this correct, you win.
Hurry up.
The bell.
Yeah,
apparently.
So, true or false, Bumblebee has never talked in a Transformers movie.
Incorrect. He speaks in the first movie. He says, I want to stay with the boy.
That is correct.
Yeah. Okay.
He actually talks multiple times through the franchise. But
he literally speaks the first movie at the end.
Mike,
it's like the last line.
You have won one of our speakers.
Oh, my goodness.
Congratulations. Dude, thank you for coming.
Oh, God, thank you.
Thank you
so
coming.
Much. Oh, my God.
You're very
this is
welcome.
A great program. Thank you.
Yes. So now we're going to welcome Bree onto our panel. Bree, what are we going to talk about?
So, I'm going to first off say that
yes,
I know little about the Transformers, but what I do know is that a lot of colleagues and even some scholars that I found on the internet have talked about Transformers as a trans allegory. So I'm gonna,
that's interesting.
Transgenderize my way into speaking more on this show, of course.
Yes.
And there's a lot of stuff. I was looking through trying to find some like specific stuff, and one of the peer-reviewed JSTOR articles, I was like, okay, peer review. was talking about Judith Butler, who is one of my favorite gender scholars, who talks about how gender is a performance, and talking about the idea of gender as a performance in Transformers. So it was really interesting to see like how they connected it. A lot of the connection, like I have my own personal connection that I can make with it, but then a lot of other people talked about how like the idea of change, and it's because a lot, you know, trans people will change how they look, how they present, and stuff like that. So obviously, you know, the Transformers will do that as well. And then there was also, it was trying to like put everything together. I have many a thoughts.
You're doing great. Thank you for educating us here.
No problem, of course. Yeah, well, I mean, obviously some people might disagree, but I'm just like basing it off of, you know, somebody asked me to speak on this, so I'm going to speak on it.
You're telling me people disagree on the internet?
People disagree on the internet? Oh, my God. Couldn't be me. No, could be me. Well, and then one thing that I did want to bring up is some people have rumored that in the new movie, I think...
Transformers Rise of the Beast.
Transformers Rise of the Beast.
Which comes out June 9th. June 9th,
yeah. They actually feature in a little bit of, I believe, the trailer. It's Arkie, who is a Transformer.
RC.
RC. I'm sorry.
It's fine.
I can't pronounce things.
It's fine.
And so a lot of people think that RC is actually transgender because, again, I'll get into it later, but Cybertronians were genderless, but RC was identified as a female because she had been experimented on by a mad scientist in order to induce gender into the species. So people were like, wow, they were genderless to gender. Now they're, you know, let's go transgenderism. So that was interesting. Unfortunately, it did turn her insane. Oopsie.
Classic movie.
Classic Hollywood.
Well, obviously, we don't know. That's in the comic, so that might not obviously be in Rise of the Beast, but it might be. Who knows? We don't know. You'll know on June 9th.
Yeah, you will.
Yes.
When you go stream it, go watch it. Well, you can't stream it. You got to watch it.
At your local movie theater.
Yes, yes, yes. And so, obviously, and then there's the two other Transformers who are Anode and Lug, who are a pair of female Transformers who were originally signed male at birth on Cybertron. And the reason why they were assigned male is that all Cybertrons were assigned as male, and female Transformers... Sorry, I'm making sure I'm quoting it correctly. And female Transformers, having currently explained circumstances, vanished from the planet. Well, undercurrent, yeah. And then, but upon leaving Cybertron, following the outbreak of the war and encountering other races throughout the galaxy, the two came better understand gender as a concept, and then they decided that female was a better fit for them. So literally transgenderism,
yeah.
Right there.
Yeah.
So it's very exciting to
Classic.
See that.
Shout
out to the airplane.
Oh my God! It's a
helicopter.
Decepticon.
I think it's the helicopter. It's just Decepticons are trying to ruin the stream.
They're trying to ruin the stream, yeah. So there's stuff like that, and then obviously a lot of people talk about Transformers as an allegory as of transgenderism in America because of people constantly having to like change who they are based on you know how other people see them or how a lot of trans people are fighting each other just because they're trying to you know get you know the approval of. You know, other humans or other people trying to figure out, you know. So it's really interesting. And I think it's not something that I've looked into a lot. So I'm sorry that it's kind of rambly. But I
no,
think it's interesting.
You've educated us. Because yeah. I didn't know about this. So
yeah,
it's interesting to hear.
Yeah, I mean, I'm going to make everything a trans allegory. So that's what I'm here for. Yeah, and that's really all I have. But
thank you, Bree, for this information, which I didn't know existed.
Yeah.
That is interesting. Thanks, Bree.
Thank you.
That is interesting.
Yes.
Assigned female, assigned male at birth, transitioned to female, two of them.
Yes.
Because they did research.
That's weird.
And they were scientifically aware of what they were doing.
Yes. All right.
Right?
So, is the what else do we have on the agenda, or is that it?
So we're going to transition to our DJ Chloe, and she's going to give us some more music to the end of this hour.
This is how we do it. It's Friday night, and I feel alright. The party's here on the west side. So I reach for my 40 and I turn it up. Designated driver, take the keys to my truck.
the shawl cause I'm faded. Honey's in the streets, say money, yo, we made it. It feels so good in my hood tonight. The summertime skirts and my guys ain't canine. All the gangbangers forgot about the drive-by. You gotta get your groove on before you go get paid. So tip up your cup and throw your hands up and let me hit a party. From here to there, if you're an OG Mac or a wannabe player, you see the hood's been good to me ever since I was a lowercase G. But now I'm a big G. The girls see I got your money, $100 bills, y'all. If you were from where I'm from, then you would know that I gotta get mine in a big black truck. You can get yours in a six ball.
Mm-hmm. be sublime. It's enjoyable to know you and the concubines. Niggas, take off your coats, ladies act like gems. Sit down, Indian styles, you recite these hymns. See, lyrically, I'm Mario Andretti on the Momo. Ludicrously speedy or infectious with the slow-mo. Heard me in the 80s, JB's on the promo. Am I never in the quest to get the paper on the caper? But now, let me take it to the queen side. I'm taking it to Brooklyn side. All the residential questers who invade the air. Hold up a second, son, cause we almost there. You could be a black man and lose all your soul. You could be white and blue, but don't prep the road. See, my shit is universal if you got knowledge of Polo or Delph or Self. See, there's no one else who could drop it on the angle. Acute at that. So, who that, do that, do that, that, that.
Come on.
Who that, do that, do that, that, that. Who that, do that, do that, that, that. I'm bugging out, but let me get back cause I'm wetting niggas. So, run and tell the others cause we are the brothers. I learned how to build mics in my workshop class. So, give me the sword and let's not make it the last.
We on a world tour with my man and my man. Going into every place, drinking up in the hand. I'm trying to watch Spokane, London, Tokyo. We on a world tour with my man and my man. Going into every place, drinking up in the hand. Houston, Delaware, D.C., Dallas.
Back in 89, I simply slid into place. Buddy, 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 all up in your face. A lot of kids was busting rhymes, but they had no taste. Some said Quest was whack, but now is that the case? I have a quest to have a mic in my hand. Without that, it's like Kryptonite and Superman. So shall he come in with the sugar cuts? Pipe towards my name, but on stage call me Dynamite. When was the last time you heard the pipe?
Thank you all for tuning in to this very special edition of Comic Corner.
Super special.
Yeah, it has been super special. Thank you for everyone that has stopped by. My name is Kaylin Guzman. And
my
this
name
is
Christian Ortiz.
Yeah, and we look forward to seeing you in theaters June 9th when Transformer Rise of the Beast comes out. For more info, follow them on social media at Transformers Movie. So yeah, thank you everyone, production crew,
yes.
All my friends that came out.
Thank you everybody that showed
everyone
up.
Everyone that stressed out with us. This has been a great show for us.
Yes.
And we're going to play out some music with DJ Chloe.
Yes. Goodbye.
Boy, you should know that I've got you on my mind. Your secret admirer. I've been watching you.
I'm a big time, I'm a gigging, yeah. Pull the trigger, yeah. I play it.